Multi-Pages now available in Adobe Express. Stick around. Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you're visiting for the first time, thank you so much for stopping by. And if you are returning, thank you as well. I'm excited to share some huge news that has been in the works for some time now, something that I've been waiting for a long, long time. And that is creating multi-pages within Adobe Express. What? That's right. You can now create multi-page projects within Adobe Express on the web. Super excited about this. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at express.adobe.com, and I'm going to start creating this multi-page project using templates. That's a great way to kind of demo here. And one of the cool things about this is that you can use this to create multi-page Instagram stories or like carousels and not have to copy one project in a separate folder. You can have it all in the same project, which is great. So let's go ahead and start with some templates here, and let's look for business and let's see what we find. Something that we can use to start off. Let me use an ad. I like this one here. I'll start from this, and then I'm going to show you a project that I've already created that are separate and how I can put them all together. So here, let me go ahead and start with this here. I'm going to remove that from the background. I'm going to crop this into a circle, and then what I'm going to do is replace this with one of my own pictures. So let's see here, I have one that I'm excited. I'll use that one there. We'll drop it in here, and there's already a filter added here. If I want to remove the filter, I can do that, but I'm going to keep what's there. And let's go ahead and let's just change this. Let's say this is a promo that I'm starting here, you know, join, let's see, my live stream. And let's go ahead and create this as magic here. And let me change this to my name here, Claudio Zavala, spell it correctly, Junior. And then down here, there's some like some information, and I'm just gonna go ahead and change this here. We'll swap that out. And for the sake of demoing, I'm just gonna use some dummy text here, Latin, or Latin, what it is here, Lorem Ipsum. And I'll just go ahead, actually just delete that here. So this will be like my starting page, or like my first, let's say it's my first carousel. So here at the bottom, if you notice here, you can add a page, you can duplicate this for the second page, which is great. That's where I was talking about. We can continue that theme, your color. And so I'll do that, I'll duplicate it. And now I'm on page two. And the cool thing about this is I'll go ahead and swap this out with another photo of mine. I'll go ahead and go to upload, and let's just go ahead and use that one there. And there we go. So now here I can create like, let's see, a date. Let's just go Tuesday, July 26th, I think is what it is. And then down here, or I should say, let's leave that. Let's add a time. Let's go ahead and add a dot there. Let's just say this is happening at 7 p.m. And then down here, we can add, you know, what it's about. So I'll just go ahead, for the sake of demoing, just leave it the way it is. And what I'll do here is make this a little bit bigger, maybe. So let's see. So here's page one, and here's page two. And let's maybe say, you know, let's add the YouTube link here. So we'll just make it up here, youtube.com/live link. You know, let's just do that here. And then what I'll do is duplicate this one, and then I can continue with editing here, changing up the photo here. So let's say I'm using that one there, and because it's pointing in the opposite direction, I'll go ahead and do something like this here. Let's move this over here, and then we'll move the text over here. And let's, looks like this right here, Let's see, we've got some shapes here, we've got a circle. Let's see. What I'm trying to do is change up the way it looks. Yeah, so let's see here. Swap that out here. Let's see, choose image. Okay, so it looks like we've got several different pieces here. There we go. Kind of getting close to the way it was on the other side. So what I'm basically doing is taking the original and changing it up a bit so that it kind of looks like, you know, we've got a design here. It's just kind of showing you how I can do that. So here we go. We've got a multi-page project, page one, page two, and then page three. You know, I can go ahead and change all this up to say we'll keep this down here just for demo sake. And a cool thing here at the bottom, I can view all the pages at once. So as I keep adding pages, I'll be able to see all of them here. Amazing way to create multi-pages. One thing I forgot to do up here, I always recommend, we're gonna call this live stream promo. So highly recommend always naming your projects. I always forget to do that. And then down here, exit view all. If I don't like this one page here, this view, I can delete it. So let's say, let's delete that and we can start over. We'll duplicate this page. And again, we are basically editing the one that we duplicated. Let's go ahead and go back and change the photo here. And I can go through the process of moving everything around, but just to give you the idea that that can be done. So this is starting from scratch, creating a multi-page project. Really saves you time instead of having to duplicate one project and having multiple ones. So now what I want to do is show you another project that I have already created. Now I want to put it all into one multi-page project. So let's go ahead and switch up here. I'm going to take something that I've already created and combine them into one project, one multi-page project. I'm going to search all my projects. And this was one I created a while back to share my top five photography tips. So all of these are separate projects, but I want them all to be in one single project. So what I'm going to do here is to start with this first one here. This is the, let's see, top five photography. Let's see what it's called, page 000. I even named each one like that. So what I'll do is come in here to edit project. And the great thing is this has already been created. And look here, what I'm going to do here is actually create and add an additional page. So notice here, it's asking me what size. I'm going to continue with this same size here. And it's basically a blank page. And this is gonna be a little bit of a, a little bit of a work to do here because I'm going to be going back and forth. But this has been saved. You can see here it's been saved. And now what I'll do is come back to projects here. I'll have my top five still here. Again, here's my first one. And this right here was my second page. So what I'll do is jump in here, and here's a cool thing. I don't have to start all over. What I'm going to do is use Control All or Command All here on my Mac. And I'm going to copy this. Just do Command C and copy. And check this out. So if you notice it's saving here, I'll wait a little bit for that to save to make sure it's there. And then what I'm going to do is come back here to projects and go to that other one. And here it is, which is right over here. If you notice it has multi-page indication right there. So I'll jump in here to this project and look at this. I'll go to the next page and check this out, Command V. And there it is. I've just copied that. So what I'm going to do now is go back and forth between my projects and add all of them into this one. I'll go ahead and do this, add a page. I'll go here, I'll add another page, do the same thing. I'm going to add about eight pages, I think seven or eight, and then I'll go back and copy and paste them into here, and I'll have one complete project, multi-page, and I can go ahead and get rid of the other one. So let me go ahead and do that and I'll be right back. I went ahead and added all my pages to create this multi-page project here in Adobe Express. I'll go ahead and show you. There's page one, and then we have two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And let's go ahead and click on view all pages. The nice thing about this here is if something is out of order, I can go ahead and move it in the right order. So you can go ahead and organize it the way you want it to be. And so that is set to go. And what I can do now is go ahead and click on download and then choose to download just this single page or all pages. And I'll go ahead and choose as a PDF. And I'll go ahead and click the start download button and it'll compress it and create a PDF for me to go ahead and share. But let's go ahead and take a look at the PDF here. Let's see, there we have it. Page 1, 2, 3, they're all just like I created there in Adobe Express. So here I am back at the project. I'll go ahead and go back to the projects window to show you the original. So here are all the single ones here. And then here is my new project. I can see there are 8 pages. So I can go ahead and get rid of all these other ones and have this single multi-page project to use in the future. There's one more thing I want to share before I close out, and that is when you are creating a multi-page project, you actually have the option to change the size of every single page. So this page is, I believe it's 8.5 by 14, as is every single page thereafter. Now, what I could do is at the very last page, if I wanted to, I could switch it up and go in a vertical format. So let's say I click on the plus sign here and I go to, let's see, this is 14 by 8.5. So I can go custom and switch it around and click on done. And now my new page will be vertical instead of horizontal. So I can go ahead and grab some of this content. I'll just copy this and paste it on. Now it will not fit exactly right. I'll have some adjustments to do, but that's fine. I can go ahead and make this look similar. So now I've got my horizontal format and then I have this vertical format. So you have the option there to change the sizes of the pages. And that's the new multi-page feature within Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this feature, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with others. And thank you once again for stopping by. And as always, be good to one another. Peace.